Hi, and welcome to lesson 14.2. We're talking about sets of real numbers, and we're trying to discover here, how can you describe relationships between sets of real numbers? So you might be wondering, well, I thought a number was a number, but no, there are different types of numbers. And here we have a situation of biologists classify animals based on shared characteristics. A cardinal is an animal, a vertebrate, a bird, and a passerine. Hello. So here, the bird is an animal, is a vertebrate. The bird is part of the vertebrates and the animals, but also the passerines are inside the birds. And so this structure, this diagram right here that helps describe the birds and where they fall into the animal kingdom, is a similar thing that we're going to see here. So what we have is our diagram. And first, you may already know that sets of rational numbers consist of whole numbers, integers, and fractions. And the set of real numbers consists of rational numbers and irrational numbers. So let's start with whole numbers. Here are some examples of whole numbers. One, and let me zoom in a little bit more here and give you more information about this. So the, let's see, I'll choose red. So the square root of four is equal to 2. That's why it's a whole number. And the whole numbers are like our counting numbers, including 0. The integers, so all of these whole numbers here, okay, they are also inside of the integers. And our integers, such as they're the positive and negative whole numbers. So you can have your whole numbers, but then the negative versions of all those whole numbers. Okay, so all of these count as integers. So if you're a whole number, you're also an integer. But just because you're an integer does not necessarily make you a whole number. And then our rational numbers. A rational number is officially a fraction of integers. So 27 is an integer, and so is 4. So a rational number is a fraction of those integers. Now the reason why, and so here, we can call this negative 6 over 7 or 6 over negative 7. Both of those would be integers. This one, 0.3, repeating now in the last lesson, lesson 14.1, I'll write this over here. So we have 0.3 repeating, that is equal to 3/9. And both 3 and 9 are both integers, so that's why it's a rational number. And then we have down here, we have 4.5 at the bottom. And 4.5, that is 4, and 5/10. So there's that's the mixed numbers count as fractions of integers. So all these are rational numbers. Now the irrational numbers would be here. And so you see lots of square roots. So mostly you're going to see square roots and pi. Pi is that real popular one. These are numbers that cannot be expressed as a fraction of integers. And when you look at the decimal version of this, I think it's pretty easy to look at this. This is 3.14159265355. And so on. This keeps on going, but there's no patterns here. And that's, so it doesn't end, so it's non-terminating, and it has no patterns there. If you look at the rational side, these all the decimals here, so this is terminating, 4.5 terminates. This one would terminate. This one doesn't terminate, but it has a repeated pattern to it. So basically, you know what the next number is going to be or where it ends. But here, you don't know where any of these decimals are going to end, or they're not going to end, first off. And you have no idea what the next number in the decimal is going to be. So they're irrational. Enough about that. Let's classify these. And, here is a big one. You can do this. We have the square root of 1, the square root of 2, the square root of 3, the square root of 4, the square root of 5, I'll stop at 9, square root of 6, square root of 7, square root of 8, and the square root of 9. So the square root of 1, what times itself is 1? 1 is. I don't know what the square root of 2 is. I know it's like 1.41 and so on, so All right, square root of 3. I don't know what times itself is 3, but I do know that 2 times 2 is 4. And I don't know this one, and don't know this one, don't know this one, don't know this one, but I do know that 3 times 3 is 9. So if we look at these, and I'll try to highlight them, I probably should have done that. So this one here, we had, they're the perfect squares, see. Everything else, if I do this, so the others are irrational. So that one's irrational, that one's irrational, that one, that one, that one, that one. All the square roots in between the perfect squares are all irrational. So that's, and so if they're irrational, there you go. The others, these are going to be, the others are rational. Okay, so that's how I generally look at this. And the square root of 5, as we can see here, the square root of 5 is right here. I don't know what that is. Oh, that looks like I just put a little, yeah, I did not mean to say that one's, it kind of looks like that. So let me just do this real quick. So, so I'm trying to color code them right there. Okay. Now, we can see that there. Let's see. This one. This is a terminating decimal. And so we can make that a fraction. And just to let you know about that, this could be negative 17 and 84 over 100. There's your fraction. Rational number. And this one is square root of 81. Let me make this bigger here. So square root of 81 is 9. Oops. Square root of 81 is 9 over 9. So really, that's just 1. And 1 is a whole number. 1 is a whole number. And if it's a whole number, then we can say it's everything else. Because back to this here, if it is a whole number, then this is inside of the integers, which is inside of the rational numbers, which is inside the real numbers. So basically, everything's going to be real because you're going to be dealing with irrational and rational numbers. But if you find something in here, it is part of everything. And that's why we have all of these descriptors for this. Let's move on to the other part of this. And I have this here. So this is your turn, and pause the video and try to answer numbers 1 and 2 before I go over it. So here we have write all the names that apply to each number. So we have this number here. What kind of number is that? Well, it's not a whole number. It's not an integer. It looks like it's a rational number. If it's rational, then it's also real. So looks like it's rational and real. And to answer this, you should go back into this graphic here, and that helps you decide where it is. It's a rational number, and that makes it also real. Okay, and the next one, the length of a side of a square that has an area of 10 square yards. Now, you might think we're just looking at 10, but we're not, because we're looking at a square. Let me bring this over here. So we're looking at a square. Awesome square. Oh, wait. I got an idea. I know what I could do. I could do this, and I can make a square, I believe. Something like that. And the area of this square is 10. 10 square yards, so yards squared. So what would these two numbers be? And that's what you're looking. So what you have to do is you have to take the square root of 10, which, hello, don't know that one. That one's irrational. So this right here, when I uncover this is irrational, and everything we're dealing with is real numbers. Okay. Understanding sets and subsets of real numbers. So by understanding which sets and subsets of types of numbers, you can verify whether statements about relationships between sets are true or false. So tell whether the given statement is true or false. Explain your choice. All irrational numbers are real numbers. Okay, so that's true because every irrational number is included in the set of real numbers. And when we're talking about sets, we're talking about this right here. Each one of these, let me erase this here, because it's kind of sloppy. So in this, we're talking about sets. So this is a set, the set of whole numbers, the set of integers, the set of rational numbers, the set of real numbers, the set of irrational numbers. And going back, we have this. So they're referencing that graphic there. And so every rational number is included in the set of real numbers, and the rational numbers are a subset of the real numbers. So it's if it's inside, then it's a subset. So no rational numbers are whole numbers. That's false, because the whole numbers can be written as a fraction, and so on. And the whole numbers are included inside of the rational numbers. So try these two for your turn, true or false, and explain your choice. Pause the video and try to answer them. Okay, so all rational numbers are integers, and that's false because, every integer is a rational number, but it doesn't go the other way around. Not every rational number is an integer. Rational numbers such as 3/5, these are not integers, but they are rational numbers. How about some rational numbers are integers? And for that, we have false as well. Real numbers are either rational or irrational, so they can go on either side. Integers are rational numbers, so no integers are irrational. You can't, and if it goes back to our graphic here, integers are inside the rational numbers here. These numbers, these integers, are not part of the irrational numbers. So there's this line right here. It does not cross that line. Okay. So we have that, and for our final page here, we have identifying sets for real-world situations. And we have real numbers can be used to represent real-world quantities, highways posted, speed limit signs that are represented by natural numbers, such as 55 miles per hour. The natural numbers are the counting numbers, not including zero. Integers appear on thermometers. Rational numbers are used in many daily activities, including cooking. For example, ingredients in a recipe often are given fractional amounts, like 2/3 cup of flour. So we're going to identify the sets of numbers that best describes each situation. So if you have the number of people wearing glasses in a room, what kind of number would be good for that? A whole number would be. Because we're talking about, it could be zero or a counting number. And how about the circumference of a flying disc, like a frisbee? Well, that would be irrational numbers because you have to multiply by pi, and pi itself is irrational. So the product would then be irrational. And so your turn here, pause the video, you know the drill, pause the video and try to answer these two before I do. So the amount of water in a glass as it evaporates. So what would be a good number for that one? Real numbers would work because you can have any number greater than zero. So you would have decimals, integers, fractions, and all that kind of stuff. How about the weight of a person in pounds? Well, what we would see, rational numbers, because you can have a decimal such as 83.5 pounds. So you might say whole numbers, but they are right. You could be in between 83 and 84 pounds. So rational numbers would be good for that. So anyway, I hope that this has been helpful for you. I hope you've learned something. Thanks for watching.